Hi, good morning. Welcome to Madhouse TV. Welcome to Rendezvous with Alysia. Today I have a long-awaited guest, Paulie Cigars from La Casa Grande Cigar Company. How are you, Paulie?
Thank you very much. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Now, who do we have here sitting
with
us?
We have Melvi Lopez, my number one roller in La Casa Grande Cigars.
Okay.
And a regular on my show, Light 'Em Up Fridays. What my real job is owning a cigar company where we do cigar events live. For your weddings, bar mitzvahs, baptisms, golf outings, what have you. We started this about 16 years ago, where we have the roller come in a full Cuban attire or a tuxedo, and we roll them right at your event, your Venise hour, your cocktail hour. It's pretty fun stuff.
Oh, very nice. Now, how'd you get involved with cigars?
Well, when I was a lot younger, I started smoking cigars when I was like 15 years old because my grandfather smoked cigars to keep the mosquitoes away. We used to call the Noblies.
Right.
And growing up, around 23, 24, I needed to do something with my life, buy myself a job. We had no cigar shops in the Bronx, period. And I thought, I'm on Arthur Avenue. You got a wonderful array of restaurants, hand-rolled, handmade mozzarella, handmade sausage. So I said, what goes better than hand-rolled cigars? So I made a place in the market. Mayor LaGuardia did that market 60-something years ago for the merchants, the street merchants, to sell their fruits, vegetables, deli product. So I brought that in there. Some people thought it wouldn't work. Some people left, and here we are. We have half the market with cigar rollers and, you know, celebrities, and it's fun. It's great, you know.
Now, you guys have rolled for The Sopranos, a couple actors. And
Sopranos, all the rap parties. We've done Jennifer Aniston, Fashion Week. We do constantly celebrity events. Gerard Depardieu, was one of my first celebrities that we did. I don't know, is he a celebrity anymore?
I think he still is. I think he's an epic one. Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I know he went crazy on an airplane one time. So.
He urinated, yeah.
Did he really?
Yeah, I think that's what he did. Didn't he urinate in first class or something like that?
Can we say that? Urinating on the show?
Yeah, urinate's a proper
Are you related to Howard Stern at all?
Do you know, I've been asked that my entire life. No.
You know, that's the only reason why I came on the show, because I thought maybe he'd be here. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, well, he can adopt me.
I'm just joking. Shouts to Gary Delabate, a very good friend of mine, producer of the Howard Stern Show. And you know, I should have asked you that question before I came here.
Then you're saying you wouldn't have come,
of
huh?
Of course I would have came. We're old friends.
Yeah.
We're old friends. I've been trying to get you on my show for a long time.
I know. I can't wait to go on. I really enjoyed it. It was at Arthur Avenue. I actually went with Evie and Vicky. We were there over the summer. We did a little filming with Giovanni, who I tried to text to call in, but I think he's still sleeping.
Gio stays in my store till about 7 in the morning, eating cannolis and drinking coffee, and then he goes to sleep, and he don't come, you know, out of his coffin until about 4 in the afternoon.
That's so funny. Now, let me ask you, I have to cut you off, because we have a really special guest calling in a couple minutes. Her name is Leah DeSimone. How do you know Leah?
Leah, before she started filming Chicago Mob Wives, came in. We became friends over Twitter, and she came in to meet me, and we did a live Light 'Em Up episode, and it just went crazy. People went nuts for her. I think she was supposed to be, she was a last-minute casting on the show, and once she got on the show, she kind of stole the show, and she got top billing. People loved her. I hate to compare people to others on other shows, but she's kind of became like the big Ange of that show, in reference to just a cult following. Wherever she goes, people know that crazy wild hair, her personality. She's nuts, crazy, and, you know, I see spinoff written all over her, spinoff show. And that's how I know her for years and years. And some of my best Light 'Em Ups are with Leah. And she's coming in for a special benefit that we're going to be doing. Could I announce that now?
Of course you can. Go ahead.
This is a bombshell. November 15th. We hooked up with Susan G. Komen Foundation for breast cancer awareness. We're doing it in November because you could do that all year round. And we're having reality stars come, mostly Italian reality stars. The topic is what it's like to be an Italian reality star in today's, you know, television world and how it affected your life. And people are going to come in. I'm going to name a few people. Others are surprises that are going to come in. We got the Carfellas from Long Island, here in Long Island. Love those guys, Tommy, Mario, and Mikey D. We have Italian hip-hop artist coming out with his own reality show. Did my theme song, Paulie Cigars King. G-Fella, Leah DeSimone's flying in from Chicago. We have a few of the Mob Wives from Staten Island coming down, and I'm going to keep some of the other names on the wraps. We can't give everything away.
Mm-hmm.
You have to come down to see us in the Arthur Avenue Retail Market, the Real Little Italy, Arthur Avenue, New York, in the Bronx.
You forgot Madhouse TV. We're coming to film.
Madhouse TV is going to be there. I'm very excited about that. You're the first person that I invited to come do that, and you're not just a guest. You're going to be filming your show there. You're one of I love this show. I catch every one of them, and it's really great what you guys are doing here. Very, very fun television.
Yeah.
And, you know, I light them up Fridays, and Alysia finally teaming up together.
I know. I'm excited. High five.
High five.
I think we have a phone call coming in. I think it's Leah. So.
Leah?
Maybe. Okay. We'll see. We'll see if that's Leah. Calling. See who's calling. So, yeah. But I'm excited. I'm glad you're here. And I see you made me my own cigars.
I made Alysia Stern cigar.
Ooh.
She's one of my favorites.
Aww.
Favorite celebrities going right now, so she deserves her own cigar. This is a double wrap, half mild, half Maduro, that we make in the store. So here's my gift to you.
Thank you.
We got only a couple. It's a limited edition. Call into the shop, 855-7-CIGARS, if you want to order the Alysia Stern. And Giovanni sends you a t-shirt. His famous line, leave the gun, take the cannoli. Oh. He makes the best cannolis in the world, not just the Bronx.
Thank you.
And it can only happen in the Bronx, remember.
That's right. I'll wear that tonight. Thank you.
Great.
I think we have a call. Let's see. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Leah.
Hi.
How are you? We were just speaking about you. How are you?
Good. I'm good. How are you?
Good, Leah.
How's the weather over there?
You know, it's really good. We are bracing for Hurricane Sandy. I personally don't think it's going to be as bad as everybody says it is, but yeah, you never know.
Well, I hope you got rain boots that are up to your knees.
Yep, I think I do. I've got a pair of galoshes that'll do me justice. But listen, tell me all about you. Tell us about the Mob Wives. How did you get cast in the Mob Wives?
Actually, I actually went on the show as a cameo.
Okay.
And when I was done filming, I received an email 2 hours later, and they said that they wanted me back. And I was skeptical only because, I mean, I never thought that I would have an opportunity on TV. And I did it as a favor. And I went back, and I was basically offered to film as full-time within a week.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Nice.
So it must have been my comedic character, I would say.
Sure. Now, what are you doing on The Mob Wives?
I'm sorry?
Well, like, who's your husband, and what are you doing? You know, like, how did your role and everything go?
I'm not married. Like I said, I just did it as a favor on the... to go on the show.
Right.
And they wanted to add a comedic role to the show.
Oh, I got
it. There I was.
Oh, and you're hot, too. I've seen your pictures.
Oh, thank
you're very
you.
Hot. Very
well, I'm
beautiful.
Stealing her from that show for Light 'Em Up Fridays. What's up, Leah?
Hi, Paulie. How
What's
are
going
you?
What's on? So I'm going to be seeing you again in a couple of weeks. I just announced it.
Yes, I will be there November 15th.
Nice.
And how does this hit home with you, baby?
I'm sorry?
How does this hit home with you?
Well, my mother has breast cancer. And she currently is on the journey. She's doing her radiation. And I have to say, she has energy like a bull, but I talked to her last night, and, you know, she was tired. So I didn't hear from her past 7 o'clock, so I know that she was sleeping.
Yeah.
Well, this is, you know, this is going to be fun. We're going to have a good time. I know your mom is fighting this, and we're going to win this battle. And this is just another step forward into fighting this. But Leah, my favorite guest on the show, fantastic. Funniest woman I've ever met probably in my life.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, funny, but sometimes I got a wicked tongue.
Yeah, she'll cut you down quick.
Oh, I can't wait to meet you. Madhouse TV is coming on the 15th, and we're actually going to be filming for the following week for my show.
Oh, well, thank you.
So, yeah,
I'll be there.
Excellent, we'll be
Who
there.
Knows, I might even come for a month, I don't know.
Oh, I hope you do, and then I'm going to grab you.
She might be working in my cigar shop, rolling cigars.
Then you have to come to Long Island then.
Yes, I will.
Yeah, well, definitely.
I'm going to make my rounds, Staten Island and then Long Island.
Oh, excellent. Well, thank you so much for calling in. We're actually going to play your video now for your Light It Up Friday Nights with Leah DeSimone.
Well, thank you. The video is very funny.
Yeah, we're looking forward to seeing it. Thank you so much,
Leah. Thank you for having me call in.
Sure. Thank you. I'll see you in 2 weeks.
See you soon, Leah. Goodbye, baby.
All right. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye. Tom, can we play that video of Leah DeSimone? Okay. Thank you.
The cell phone be up and running. I can't do
try
it.
Try to do it. I know the light's bad, but testing. One microphone check. 1, 2.
So push red or
turn. Assassin with the roughneck business.
Okay, now what? You already said something. So now how do you make sure it works?
Hey, you meatball.
You want sugar? Hello, how you doing? You want sugar?
Yeah, I want sugar, and not yours either.
I'm not offering. You're not the wrong guy. That's Mike.
I want sugar, and don't lace it either. I'll bust your head open.
How do you say it in Chicago? Bust your hole?
I'll bust your head open.
No, what'd you say to me in there?
I'll hit you with a shovel.
No, what did you say to him about a chair?
Yeah.
What the hell did you say?
Did you just take
you said something
kind of
like, what are you talking
about? Of us, like,
what do you mean?
You were in there, you said your brother used to say.
Oh, my brother used to say, I'll split your, no. How would Michael say it? Oh. That motherfucker just bought a turban.
A turban? Yeah.
Oh,
what the hell is that?
What's that?
A turban. He split his head open.
Should have said another half hour.
Good. Don't take 2 hours. Don't take 5.
Oh, let's go with this show, right? Right, asshole?
17 hours. Chips away.
I don't care what y'all say. Whoa, it's time to rock and roll.
Another Light 'Em Up Fridays. Here we have a special celebrity guest here. What the fuck do you want me to say?
Oh, he's doing good!
What?
You gotta be more animated, bro.
Want me to do cartwheel?
Yeah.
Today we have a special guest here with Leah from Chicago Bob Wives.
Leah DeSimone, a very good friend of ours, coming down from Chi-Town. You know, rocking in New York for about, 2 days?
I'll be here till Monday. Who knows, maybe I'll make it longer.
New York will never be the same.
Look at this fucking treatment you get. Like, who the hell are you to get this treatment?
Now, wasn't that hysterical? That's Leah DeSimone. Love her. From Chicago Mob Wife. She just called in. As you heard, on November 15th, Madhouse TV will be filming at the Pastoria on Arthur Avenue, and it's for breast cancer. And Leah's mom, prayers go to her, and we will see you on Thursday. We're cutting to a commercial now. When we come back, we're going to learn about how to roll cigars, and we have a couple more surprises. Guests calling in, so enjoy the commercials.
Hi, this is Mickey B, the Prince of Rock and Roll. Join me for my rock and solid gold holiday dance party Saturday, December 1st, 8 p.m. at the Belmore Columbus Club, 2333 Belmore Avenue in Belmore, with the rockin' sounds of the 50s through the 80s, starring the Accords, the Fabuliers, Third Edition, and DJ Ace playing all your rocking hits. Party with Santa, Full Hot Buffet, Coffee Dessert Cash Bar, reservations required. Call 516-822-9612, 516-822-9612, or MickeyB.com. Sponsored by...
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. till 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. till 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hog's hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
B&M Performance Cycles, 439 South Main Street, Messina, New York. We handle all parts, accessories, and do all repairs. We can custom build your bike for show or hot rod. We also do New York State inspections on all motorcycles. B&M Performance Cycles. Come see us today.
This is Paulie Cigars, and welcome to Madhouse TV. Today we're going to be showing you more about cigar rolling, the lost art that I rediscovered about 16 years ago, old world Cuban style. We have Melvi here rolling. Today he's using a Connecticut shade wrapper, that's the outer wrapper. That's from the great state of Connecticut here in America. The fillers are from the Dominican Republic, his hometown in Nicaragua. What he's doing out right now is actually the finishing, which you would see at your event, golf outing, red carpet, pink carpet event. And the inside of it, what we do there in the molds, those molds are about 70 years old, wooden molds. And they are pressed for about an hour before they could take cigar form. And what we do is, what they do is they take some tobacco in one hand from Nicaragua, some tobacco from in the other hand from Dominican, mix them together, bind them with the binder, which is a tobacco leaf. It's all tobacco, and we press it for about an hour, and the finishing touches we do with either a Brazilian Maduro for a stronger taste or a Connecticut shade wrapper for a more mild taste. And these guys have been doing this for years upon years. They're masters, they're artisans, they're not my workers, they're the stars of the show when you come down to Arthur Avenue.
You know what I wanted to ask you? I've seen, speaking of the car fellas before, I was going to call them the car wives. Sometimes, like, Tommy has a cigar, it's like this thick. I mean, is there a difference between the way you're rolling this and those big ones? Is it just the amount of filling, or?
Actually, Tommy just came out with his own cigar called La Dolce Vita. I made him a cigar, and him and Giovanni had an argument whose cigar was bigger and who had the signature cigar, but Tommy's a great friend of mine. We actually talked late last night. He loves a big 70 ring gauge, and that's the girth of a cigar.
Okay.
He likes a big fat bad boy, and it's strong, and that's his signature when you see him.
Yeah, always.
I think we're going to collaborate on a cigar together. He's a great friend of mine. Carfellas are going to be at this event as well. And they'll be there signing autographs, chilling with their fans. Maybe Tommy will pull up in one of his signature Cadillacs and his cigar hanging out of his mouth.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
That would be, I like him. I interviewed them on Mikey D's Stoop, and Tommy's laugh gets me every time.
Tommy's a dear friend of mine.
Every time. I think we have another phone call. Let's see who's calling in. Hello, Madhouse TV.
Yeah, hi, this is Squiggy.
Hi, oh, Squiggy. No.
Listen,
how'd you get this?
I told you at 11:22. What am I, a fucking astronaut? Am I going into space?
Yeah, I think you are.
Who told you to call here? How'd you find this number?
I found it in the bathroom.
In the bathroom.
That's right, in Boxdale, they put him in the bathroom. Put him in the bathroom. He was in the bathroom with Gigi, JoJo the Whale, and who else?
I put them in the bathroom.
Oh, you put them in the bathroom. Okay, all right.
I was the bedroom ear, or the bedroom door, ear, or something like that.
Yeah, tell me about your role, all your movie roles. I heard you won an Academy Award, and you won.
Actually, I did.
Yeah,
I did. I won for Best Villain in a Feature Film.
Nice.
Yes, there's a movie called Bronx Paradise. I think it's on Amazon, it was on Fios, and they're promoting it now to be on HBO, so I don't know what's going to happen with it, but it was kind of a good film. I was really, really surprised. You know, I didn't want to go out there. I figured I was getting some, major actors. And I said, who the hell knows who I am? And I wind up winning, which is,
Who'd you beat out?
I'm looking at my award now as we're talking.
Who did you beat out for this award, Squiggy?
I beat one of my favorite actors in the whole world, Michael Madsen, Reservoir Dogs.
Oh, you beat him. Oh, wow. Nice.
Yes, James. I mean, these are real, real actors. I don't know how I even got nominated. How I won is beyond me, but I did. It was a great, it was a real, real great feeling.
And what was it like being in the Bronx Tale?
It was great. I spent 3 months on it, and it was great. Yeah, it was like I'm from the neighborhood, so it was like reenacting my neighborhood. So it was kind of good. It was kind of good. The guys I met over there were still friends after all those years. We just had a reunion in Baltimore in Chaz's restaurant out there called Chaz, which and everybody from the movie was there.
Which I think is brilliant to have a reunion for a movie called The Bronx Tale about Bronx and Arthur Avenue in Baltimore.
Who thought of that idea? Bizarre. But it's not with a B anyway. Bronx, Baltimore, without the... They got halfway right.
Okay. So what else? You finished?
What?
I'm just kidding. So what else is going on with you, baby? You're going to come to...
I'm actually doing something with you.
I know. Where am I? In Long Island.
You're in Long Island?
Yeah.
Yeah, keep him there. Keep him in Long Island, believe me.
I may. He's rolling. He rolled me a bunch of cigars. He's rolling all the cigars.
Is he, oh, yes? Oh, that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool. He's gonna keep him out there. I hope you don't get deported from Long Island. That'd be embarrassing.
Well, tell us, what are you doing with Paulie now? What do you guys got going on?
Okay, we're doing our show. It's a cigar show. It's his idea. It's a great show. He's terrific in it, actually. He's really, really good. I'm not saying because he's there and because I'm going to take about 47 cigars when I go to the place, but he was really good. Great idea. Some funny stuff in there. Really funny stuff.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see when they find the final editing on it. It's really, really good.
Well, what he's talking about right now is Light 'Em Up Fridays. That other concept hasn't been green-lighted at all. We don't know where it's going, but Light 'Em Up Fridays is a fixture. So you can see him once a week on there, and it's funny, and he does come and takes 90 cigars for his pay.
Yeah, well, I get paid. he was going to be cash, but I don't think he could use Monopoly money anywhere. So we're working on cigars.
And if it don't work out, we're all going to move to El Rio Lamo.
I'm having a place. You can go on the lamb. It's called Rio Lamo. You go over there, you stay for the rest of your life with eight pirates and a palm tree.
Eight pirates and a palm tree. All right, well, thank you. We actually have one of your videos that we're going to play right now from you on Light 'Em Up Fridays.
Yes.
So we're going to play that.
Good.
And then Madhouse TV will be at your breast cancer charity event on the 15th. So we will see you on the red carpet.
Oh, I'm looking forward to seeing you. Paulie, I'm not really looking forward to seeing you, so if you can stay in Long Island, stay there.
I'll stay in the bathroom.
Listen, thank you. Had a great day. It was fun talking to you.
I'll see you in the market in a few minutes,
See you in the market. Bye, baby.
Okay, bye. Take care. Tom, do we have that clip of Squiggy? Okay, thanks. Let's play that.
All right. This is really a class fucking place.
Clark Abel didn't get this much attention. What the fuck?
Maybe Clark disabled.
Light 'Em Up Fridays for YouTube. This ain't the Johnny Carson show.
The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea. It lingered there to touch your hair and walk with me. All summer long we sang a song. And then we strolled that golden sand.
Welcome to another Light 'Em Up Friday. Due to popular demand, we have our good friend back, Ralph Squiggy Squillante, back here with us at the Arthur Avenue Retail Market. What's up, Squig?
Do I get paid for this?
Anything you want. You got the cigar. Enjoy. You're smoking slow.
Well, we got a new nickname for Squiggy, Squiggles.
Squiggles.
Oh, calm down.
Well, wait, we got Squiggles, we got Squeegee.
Squigman.
Guy called me Squeegee. He thought I was like a homeless person fixing fucking windows, washing windows.
Do you have any, good stories, like from Riddlers, like fighting stories or anything, like when you were Blood and Guts, anything like that?
Well, my place was like the Mekong Delta. You know what I mean? During Vietnam, there was more bodies in the nightclub over there. They called me up one time. I'm out someplace else. They said, "Ralph, you got a little problem. They stabbed two guys." I said, "I thought it was something serious for a minute." I said, "They even stabbed them?" I said, "Oh, that. I didn't want to show up. It didn't matter." I said, "Over there, they had like bazookas, grenade launches, heavy artillery. This guy, you never know. Everybody could stick you up. The hatchet girl could stick you up. The bar maid could stick you up." It was a kind of bizarre world.
So the stabbing was no big deal?
Absolutely nothing. He was just semi-wounded.
Okay.
I think he took his appendix out without his permission.
It lingered there.
nothing.
I'll tell you a funny story when I went to Riddler's with Paul. We had a Christmas party for a bunch of bouncers from Rascals.
Yeah, but this, the only problem was it was in October. Okay.
And 30 strong, you're talking about wrestlers from Hunter College, bodybuilders from wherever. We all got together, and I was 17 years old, and I was amazed by all these guys, the way they can drink. Paulie, who's now not a drinker, had consumed 22 scotches. No water, no ice, straight scotch. Do you remember the brand of scotch?
Shivers Regal.
Shivers Regal, okay. So we went out for dinner.
Shivers.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And then we went into Riddler's. And we had a running joke. We used to say, if you farted, like an Italian person would say, summon a bitch.
Well, who fucked thee?
Who fucked thee? And nobody would understand what that means.
He was. Well, I still don't understand what it means.
So he was.
He just said it to me.
He was so drunk. He was going up to everybody in Riddler's and going up to him, grabbing him, go, summon a bitch, but who fucked thee?
You must have been a real hit that day. I'm sure everybody loved him. The girls were lining up to meet him.
Wasn't that an awesome clip with Squiggy? So thank you so much. We are actually going to cut to a commercial, and when we come back, we are going to roll a cigar from scratch.
Scratch.
From scratch. So tune in. Thank you to all our sponsors. If you want to sponsor one of our shows, please call Madhouse TV at 631-669-7999. I think I got the number correct this time. I did. Woo-hoo. Anyway, we're going to cut to a commercial. Thank you to all our sponsors, and enjoy.
Chris, doing a reading. Let's see what's going on.
Okay, I've never had a reading like this before, so just bear with me. I'm seeing bugs.
Bugs? I thought you were a psychic medium.
I know, that's what's confusing. Hold on. Do you want the good news or the bad news?
I'll take the bad news.
I think these are spirit bugs.
Spirit bugs? I've never heard of spirit bugs.
That's just it. Do you want the good news?
Yes.
I know Joe from Bug Busters of Long Island. He'll take care of your problem.
That's great.
Hi, I'm Vinny, owner of VMD Electric. Family owned and operated since 1996, serving all of Nassau and Suffolk County. You can call us anytime, night or day, at 631-669-6915 for all your residential and commercial needs.
Here are some photos of our current projects.
Welcome back to Madhouse TV. We have another call coming in, so I'm going to answer this call. We're so busy today, Paulie. Hello, Madhouse TV.
Hello.
What up, G-Fella?
Yo, what up? Is that my man, Paulie Cigars?
What's up, G-Fella? What's going on? Thank you for taking the time to call us, baby.
No problem, man. I told you I'm over here with my son at the flag football game. I had to put the other coach in there and let him rock out, so I go on the sideline, call my man, Paulie Cigars.
Nice. So tell me a little bit about you, G-Fella.
Well, you know, I'm an Italiano hip-hop superstar.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, you know, I'm an Italian hip-hop artist. You know, I got a TV show coming out on Fuse in March. You know, we got the whole Italian hip-hop movement, you know, so just doing my part for hip-hop, you know, just bringing my flavor, my story, you know, for the kids out there repping what we do and what we're around and what we grew up around, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, linking up with a guy like Paulie Cigars is easy. That's normal. That's family, you know?
Right, we're family. Yeah. It's like my brother.
How did you meet Paulie?
Well, you know, I'm always down in the neighborhood over there in Arthur Avenue, and, you know, Paulie Cigars is Arthur Avenue, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, we met each other through mutual friends, and...
We don't mention names on camera. Gee, man, I was telling about that video you made for me, man. I love this guy like a brother, and he's actually going to be at that November 15th Breast Cancer Awareness fundraiser, and he's so relevant right now as an artist, and what he's doing is amazing. I mean, if you just listen to his music, some of the best hip-hop out there is coming from G-Fella, and his show is hysterical. When that comes out, number one reality show written all over it.
Now, how did, so you ready, you signed your contracts, it's all a go, you're going to be on the Fuse station?
Yeah, we shot it already.
Excellent.
We shot it in the summer. It's being edited as we speak. It's pretty much almost done. They're going to start doing promotion top of the year. And it airs in March.
Nice. How does that feel?
Oh, it was awesome. You know, it's definitely like, it's like you're getting paid to hang out pretty much because you're doing what you're doing normally, you know, but you're getting paid for it. So it's hilarious. It's hilarious. It's actually amazing that they made a business out of that. But, you know, it is. It's just funny because, you know, every guy's story or every woman's story is interesting, I guess, in its own right. So reality TV is huge because of that, you know. People want to take a look at other people's lives. And it's nuts.
Yeah, definitely. It's like the hottest new thing. I don't even know. Between the news and embracing for Hurricane Sandy and watching reality TV, I think is all, you know, anybody's going to be doing this weekend.
So. Oh, yeah. As long as the power stays on, you got to have a generator. I got a guy for the generators if you need him.
Oh, okay, good.
If you ever need any, if you ever need anything, man, G-Fella got a guy.
G-Fella's got a guy.
That's his,
well, thank
that's his
you.
Tag.
We
how
actually,
you doing?
Yeah, we actually have your video, right? We're going to play it now, the music video that you made for Paulie Cigars. So thank you so much for calling in, and we're going to play your video now. And
see you tonight at your Halloween party, baby.
That's it, brother. We do it up real big, man. It ain't all about hip-hop, man. We friends, we brothers, we family, and that's what this whole thing is about. And everybody got to support each other. Support the radio station, support you, support Paulie, support me, gfella.com, that's it. If we don't do this, and help each other out, then we're just a bunch of mutts.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing your new TV show. I'll be tuning in to Fuse in March to watch you, G-Fella. Thank you so much for calling. Tom, can we play that video, please? Thanks.
All right, take it easy.
Okay, love bye.
G-Fella, Big Paulie Cigars. When you're the best at what you do, you know you're the king of what you do. So kings hang with kings.
I'm a king, I'm a king.
La Casa Grande Cigars.
I'm a king, I'm
go and see them on off the ramp in the Bronx.
Fuck the MCs, to call me size. I'm a king,
it's G-Fella and Big Paulie Cigars.
I'm a king, I'm a king.
La Casa Grande Cigars.
I'm a king,
go and see them on off the ramp in the Bronx.
Fuck the MCs, yeah. To call me.
G-Fella and Big Paulie Cigars.
If you don't know who the king, then you're living on Mars. La Casa Grande in the Bronx, Big Paulie Cigars. Off the red, born and raised, ass around, he self-made. The original, seen it all. Fame to the rays, cigars for the stars. Edison to Gandolfini, politicians, George Bush to Giuliani. Humidors empty, sell them fast as they roll them. Torpedoes, Churchills, Robustos, Coronas. Fat 60 ring gauge, Casa Grande size. Charles double Coronas, whatever they the guys. Best of the best, why they worldwide. LCGcigars.com, visit online. Comp can't touch their blends of grades of tobacco. Cuban style of bundles and butcher paper that wrap you. Made by hand daily, best rollers in the business. Quality control, Comp can't even get near this. Aim for Hunter Blaze of the classic Mag 7. Even in a cloud of smoke, you feel like you're in heaven. Many different lines, got something for everybody. They rich, rare, rewarding. Bring out your inner bosses. One and only true smokers will agree. Bought the lost art of cigar rolling the NYC. Original, wise co-signed by me. La Casa Grande Cigars, Big Paulie and G. Let's go! Casa Grande Cigars. Go and see them on off the ramp in the Bronx. Grande Cigars on Light 'Em Up Fridays. You get a little, you know, a little glimpse into the world we live. G Fella, Paulie Cigars.
I'm the king, I'm the king.
Now I'm gonna go smoke my cigar. See you later.
Thank you, G Fella, for creating such a phenomenal, you know, music video. What does that feel like? You have your own music. You have your own song.
I can't even tell you how overwhelming that was for such a relevant artist to do that for me.
Mm-hmm.
And just asked me if he could do it, and I said, wow, really? And then when he said the music video, I didn't believe it. I thought it was a joke, but when he did it, I can't even just tell you the words. He is a true friend, a true brother. I love the guy. He's probably one of my best friends. And I'll be on his show, and hopefully we're going to just grow together. It's great.
That's what it's about.
It's about
family
that,
and teamwork. Definitely. So what do you got going on here?
Before I tell you about that, I forgot to mention Leah DeSimone Cigar, Baby Wolf, coming out, Signature Series. It's going to be coming out by Christmas, so keep your eyes open for that. Her website, LeahDeSimone.com. You can Google that and find it. We're doing, we're going to show you a cigar from scratch, how to make it. So what we do is we take two different types of leaf. One leaf is more mild than the other. So in Spanish, one is called seco, one is called ligero. Ligero is full-flavored, strong. If you want a mild cigar, you use more of this than this. If you want a strong cigar, you use more of this with this. This is from Mexico, actually. This is from Nicaragua. And what he does is he puts the two together before we put them in that mold. And this is called a binder. And this binder is from Indonesia. It's got a lot of spicy flavor. And this is a signature cigar. We don't just make this for anybody. And this is the starting process. This is building the cigar. And when people come, they want to see this mostly because this is actually how, you know, a lot of people don't know the work, the artisanship that goes into something like this. He puts the tobacco together, break it apart, and what he's going to do is he's going to bind it. This is going to keep the cigar together, so when it's being molded, the cigar takes form and takes shape. And that's the beginning process of this. After he actually rolls the cigar, actually it's the inside, he's going to use this gum. It's a derivative for vegetable. We crush it, we make it into a paste. It's kind of a gum. And sometimes you could put sugar or sweetener in there to make it with some sweetness or flavor. And that, before it's rolled into a regular cigar, it's going to be pressed in a press for about an hour to take a form into a cigar like this. And what he's been doing throughout the show is the finishing touches. So, hace un cigarro. I actually speak Spanish, believe it or not. So, guys from Arthur Avenue, learn how to speak Spanish as well. Not only Italian. And that's this is the final part. This is what you're going to see at your events. After it's pressed for about an hour, this right here takes a lot of skill to just keep no bumps, no flaws. To actually be able to do this, I would say it takes about 10 years of practice and learning and being taught by the best. And he is actually being mentored by the supervisor of my shop. When Melvi came to me for employment, he kind of knew how to make cigars. He was from DR, and I gave him a shot. He's actually one of my best rollers, probably the best roller I have. So he put his mind to it, and that's the finished product.
Now, when somebody smokes a cigar, how long does it usually take for someone to actually finish a cigar? Does it depend on the person, or is there like, does each cigar come with like a limitation of puffs, so to speak?
You can, if it's a hobby, you could sit there for 2 hours with cognac. Usually when you cut a cigar and light it, you don't like it to go out because that smoke will congeal within the cigar and make it taste like an ashtray.
Yeah.
So people like to just relax, light it, and sit there and let it, and that's the hobby. Habit, you could smoke a two-hour cigar in 30 minutes. I mean, I started doing that a couple of years ago, and it became I was smoking all day long. You know, and then it takes the enjoyment. It's like having a fine wine, you know, the palate has to pick up those creamy, nutty notes or coffee flavors or cocoa, whatever the cigar, what goes into that cigar, that tobacco is being aged. All my tobaccos age 10 years and 10 and 20 years before I buy it. So I smoke them fresh. There's a lot of talk about a cigar being aged. Well, the tobacco needs to be aged, not the cigar. So I love smoking them fresh. And all the tobacco is aged. Wherever it's laying around, it's going to pick up those characteristics, whether it's leather, whether it's orange peels, whether it's cocoa. And like a wine, it's the same thing like a cigar. You're going to pick up those characteristics as you're smoking it. And that's the hobby of a cigar, and enjoying it.
And now, you can dip them in liquor or liqueurs and
some
stuff?
Some people dip them in RCA, cognac, some St. Louis the 13th. A lot of people do that at events. We'll have a cordial station. People dip them. A lot of cigar snobs, as they call them, won't do that. You know, there's a lot of people that have their own rituals when it comes to cigar smoking. Me, I just bite off the tip. I don't cut it, and I light them with regular matches. That's just my thing. I let it go out and relight it. But some other people are very, you know, fussy about the way it's cut, the way it's snipped, the way it's punched, the back of the cigar, the way it's lit with cedar sticks, lit. I don't know what I said. The way it's lit or gas butane. They don't want to use matches because of the sulfur, because it might infuse with the cigar taste. So, and that's another, you know, way to enjoy a cigar.
Very nice. So we have to cut to a commercial again. So we're going to cut to a commercial. When we come back, I'm going to finish enjoying my afternoon with Paulie Cigars from Arthur Avenue. Enjoy the commercial.
This is Mickey B, the Prince of Rock and Roll. Join me for my Rock and Solid Gold Holiday Dance Party, Saturday, December 1st, 8 p.m. at the Belmore Columbus Club, 2333 Belmore Avenue in Belmore, with the rocking sounds of the 50s through the 80s, starring the Accords.
The Fabuliers, third edition, and DJ Ace playing all your rocking hits. Party with Santa, Full Hot Buffet, Coffee Dessert Cash Bar, reservations required. Call 516-822-9612, 516-822-9612, or MickeyB.com. Sponsored by...
Welcome back to Madhouse TV, Rendezvous with Alysia Stern. Thank you for having me. This is a fantastic, fantastic show. I'm very excited about it. I can't wait to watch it.
I know. I love when I go home, and you put it on. You can go to www.madhousetv.com and just go to show archives, and then you can go to my show and you can watch it. But by the time you get home, it'll probably be on YouTube. It'll be all over the place. I'll Facebook it, Twitter it.
My fans in Bangladesh will enjoy it.
Yes, they will. Now, I think I follow G Fella on Twitter. I think we're Twitter friends. He really does some great stuff.
His work is phenomenal. His videos are amazing.
Yeah.
Videos are amazing. The work on that is great. GFella.com, YouTube G Fella. Gets 300-something thousand hits. I mean, he just releases something. The guy's amazing, fantastic.
Yeah, now you have some really great friends. You hang out with the guys from the Mama's Boys of the Bronx. You hang out with Academy Award winning actors. You hang out with Leah from the Mob Wives, a couple of Mob Wives. I know you told me about some other stuff that you have going on. I mean, to me, you're living the life. Tell me more about you.
Well, I mean, you know, I come from the Bronx. I hate to say come from the streets. Nobody really comes from the streets, but I never, ever thought I would be able to be working for anybody or doing.
Sure.
So I always came and did my own thing. And, of course, with that, territory comes with trouble once in a while. And if you Google the name Paulie DeSilvio, you'll read all about that. And that's an interesting story in itself. But I try not to dwell on that too much and exploit that, because I want kids to know that no matter what adversities you come against and what trouble you get in your life, you don't have to get the job at McDonald's if you don't want to. Nothing wrong with that. You could be an entrepreneur and be a millionaire again and again and again, lose it all and get it again if you just put your mind to it. Coming from Arthur Avenue, being Italian comes with a lot of stereotypes, so most of my problems probably stem from that. I don't have those problems anymore. My problem in my life is... am I gonna make it a cappuccino or an espresso? I mean, that's my problems right now. I got a beautiful baby boy, Hunter. His mom, Lisa's fantastic. She's an amazing woman. So I got a lot of positive people in my life. I got a great business. And 2 years ago, just having a little baby boy and thinking that I probably won't see him for a while, and a couple of years later, actually doing all this that I'm doing, sitting here and hanging out with you and talking about fun stuff like this. I mean, who's better than us? We don't have problems. Nobody really, life is great.
Mm-hmm.
Life is great. So this is fantastic. And yeah, I didn't, don't call it a comeback. Like LL says, I've been here for years, and we're going to keep on coming, and no matter what comes my way, I'm going to overcome that. And we're just going to make things happen. And doing this breast cancer awareness, after that, we want to do something against bullying. I hate bullies. And that's something, what happened recently to a young lady jumping off a bridge here in New York over bullying disgusts me, and I want to attack that next. And it's just all about giving back. Like G Fella says, we got to help each other. If we don't help each other, we don't do something for each other, the next one, you're living life, for yourself. And you ain't going to get, you might get somewhere, but you're not going to get where you want to be, and everybody's going to pass you by.
Right. Now, you know who I want to ask you about? Your little co-host on your Light 'Em Up Friday show. Where is he?
Paulie.
Yeah.
Well, somebody had to watch the register.
Oh, you're right. Does he own the store with you, or he just works there?
No, Paulie P, he hangs out with me, been through it just like me, had everything, and, when life throws you lemons, you make lemonade, and now we're just doing Light 'Em Ups together, and he's one of the funniest guys I know,
mm-hmm.
Paulie P, cousin Paulie. And me, him, and Squiggy just jive, and we mesh well. And sometimes you won't see him on the show for a while. When he does come on, he makes it very funny. And when I'm not there, he mans the shop. So he did send you his love. He can't wait to see you on the 15th. And he actually does add a lot to Light 'Em Up Friday's cigar show.
Well, you know what we have to do right now? I mean, We got Mikey D. We got Paulie Cigars. We got Johnny Meatballs. We got all these names. Now, Tom Mealy is done. We call him Gelman. I mean, now I feel like we got to lose. My co-host, Corinne, came up the name Gelman for him. But I feel like we need to give Mealy an... I don't know. We got to give him a name before the 15th, because when Madhouse TV comes to film your red carpet event, we got to give Tom a nickname, because he really wants to do one of your light 'em up cigar shows with you, but we got to give him a nickname. So I think we have homework to do the next 2 weeks. We got to lose Gelman and come up with another name for Mealy.
Well, what does he do best?
What does he do best? He runs this, he runs Madhouse TV. He rides his motorcycle. He's, you know,
what do they call him now?
Well, one day, Corinne and I were filming the show, and he was like, I don't know what he was doing. He's fixing lighting, taking down sheetrock, and Corinne called him Gelman. Like on the Regis and Kathy, there's always
Gelman. Say it all together, his first name and last name.
Tom Mealy. But Gelman doesn't go.
Tommy Madhouse.
Tommy Madhouse?
Tommy Madhouse. All right. We figured that out in 2 seconds.
Tommy Madhouse.
Tommy Madhouse.
Or is Vicky saying Madhouse Mealy or something more?
Forget about the Mealy. Tommy Madhouse.
Tommy Madhouse. All right, so we're going to do a light 'em up Friday night cigar show with Tommy Madhouse.
Oh, I can't wait for that.
Yeah?
He's a funny dude.
Yeah, he's funny. He really is funny.
And he made my experience before I got on this set very, very interesting and had a lot of laughs, so thank you for that.
Yeah, I want you to come back. I want you to come back after the holidays, come back with Squiggy, come back with Giovanni. Now, do you think we can get Giovanni up to get here by 10?
If he leaves the door open in his house, I'll wake him up and try to pick him up and carry him over here. He's a big, muscular guy, so I don't know if I'll be able to do that, but you have to have him on your show because he's hysterical.
He's so funny.
Best storyteller, and he's got a heart of gold.
Yeah.
A heart of gold. So for a guy who's been through it, a lot of nonsense in the last 10 years, undeserved, that guy's a heart of gold and lives life to the fullest, most positive guy I know.
Yeah, I think we might have one video with him, but we're going to wrap it up right now, and I'm going to actually air that on my show next weekend, and I'm going to make him. Oh, we can do it now? We do have time. Okay, there's one, The Remembering When.
Oh, I love that.
Is that it, The Remembering When?
When we're talking about the old days.
And I'm just going to make him, I'm going to make him call into my show next week just because I love him to death. I'm going to make him get up. But I think it's called Remembering When, Light Him Up Friday, so we have that. Okay, hit it, Tom.
Napolo quando solo t'abbandona, lo cielo se fa tutta color d'ora, a campana do carmana casola, se canta nonna, e nonna nonna,
welcome to Light 'Em Up Friday Cigar Show. I'm Cousin Paulie. I'm sitting here with Paulie Cigars and a good friend from the neighborhood, Giovanni Paolo.
Today, we're going to be talking about the old days, the way the neighborhood, and I know we've been talking about it a lot. Cigar of the week's going to be a nice sugar dipped Maduro. It brings you back. We were talking about Avanti's.
And no, the Nobilis.
The Nobilis.
Back in my grandfather's days, 40, 50 years ago, when all the Jabonis came off the boat, that's all they used to smoke, guinea sticks.
Oh.
Some call them guinea stinkers, we call them guinea sticks.
The whole house stunk.
Yeah.
The whole house.
Well, it was really to keep the mosquitoes away.
Yeah.
So we're going to throw this in with every $50 purchase and over. So if you want to buy $1,000 worth of cigars, I'd appreciate that. But $50 and over, you put in the code word, sugar. Sugar. There you go.
Sugar.
Next time, the next call word is going to be guinea sticks.
I can't write that. That's not politically correct. Good friend of mine, Jake LaMotta.
A lot of the Sons of Italy suing us.
Remember we had dinner with Jake that time? Jake LaMotta, he said he got hit so many times by sugar, he caught diabetes. Let's get to this week's raffle.
Cholo!
Going to have one of my rollers pick it out. Nicknamed Cholo.
Yeah. He rolled me some from the cigar, my man.
Hey, he rolled that today.
Yeah, it's beautiful. This is how I always want my cigar.
Keep the owner. And this week's winner is Marianne Beretta. Marianne Beretta, We're going to give you a shot. You tell us which bundle you like, and it's on us. Keep entering via Facebook, Twitter. Like our page.
Thank you. Thank you for watching that video. I was hoping Giovanni would have woken up and called in, but next time he will. Tom, can you come here, Tom? Tom, I know you love cigars. Come here. Come light one up.
I have a surprise for him.
Got a surprise for him?
Yeah.
Hey, Tommy Madhouse, come here.
Can I sit over here?
Come sit over here, yeah.
You know I love cigars.
I know you do. That's why I had to do this for you.
You know I love cigars.
The Alysia Stern. Tommy Madhouse, my brother.
That's Alysia Stern?
Yeah.
You know, I've done a lot of things with women, but I never smoked one before. All right, so you want me to light this?
Yeah, go ahead, Tom. Enjoy. No.
Hold on, I got to get in the mode.
Okay.
All right, can I get in the mode first? You got the kick? Can I get in the mode? Hold on a second.
Yeah, okay. Well, we should both do that. Hold on. He ain't going to be with the men in black.
Paulie, these are his cigars. Let me tell you something. If you haven't had an opportunity to watch his show, you've got to watch the show. Now, this is going to be a first here. Now, if these fire alarms go off, we really don't give a shit because when it comes to smoking cigars, we do whatever it takes. Am I right?
All day, every day.
What time?
How's that?
That's the Alysia Stern.
Does it do
it
justice?
Sucking on Alysia Stern. I mean, on the cigar.
Oh, it smells so good. I love the smell of a cigar.
And with that, I turn it back over to you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you, Leah, for calling in. Thank you, Paulie, for being here. Thank you, Squiggy. Thank you, G-Fella. Thank you, Giovanni, for sleeping in, because I'll get you on again. We will be on the red carpet with Paulie Cigars, all the reality TV show people, on November 15th for breast cancer. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for rolling all the cigars.
Light them up.
Light them up, everybody. Enjoy. Have a wonderful, safe Halloween. Thank you.
Enjoy.